Hello everyone, welcome to the Java course. When we create some methods for a class, is it able for that method to rely on other methods that are created on your own? Yes, we can. Actually, we can create private methods or what we call the inner methods so that a method is relying on other methods. So let us see some examples of the inner methods. I have a computer class. And for the instance variables, I have one about the memory size of a computer, and the other one is about the storage size of a computer. And then I have a constructor. For simplicity, I ignore the accessors and mutators. So for my computer class, I want to set up one method like this. I want to check whether a particular computer object is actually a flagship server. So my idea is like this. I want to rely on a method called high memory, high storage. That means if a computer is having high memory, and at the same time if it has a large storage as well, I can claim that computer object a flagship server. So this is actually a method that I need to create in the next step. But when I create this method, I can use the access modifier private. So now I'm going to create an inner method. Okay, you can see that I use the word private to indicate that this method is a private method. What does it mean by a private method? It means that this method is only accessible within the computer object scope. That means we can't call this method when we are already outside the computer class. So our driver class is not able to call the method, which is a private one, directly. Of course, the computer class has the rights to call the object directly. So you see in the its flagship server method, I simply make use of the inner method name to determine whether the computer is a flagship server. So how can I create the private method? I need some local variables. Why do we call them local variables? Because the scope of these variables is only in this high memory, high storage function only. My definition of a large memory is 64 gigabytes. And my definition of a large storage is the situation when the computer has 20 terabytes of storage size. So how can I determine whether a computer object is really a flagship server? Okay, if the computer object is able to pass this condition, I will say that the computer object is actually a flagship server. If this condition is not satisfied, I will say that the computer is not really a flagship server. So I simply return the boolean value coming from the comparison of two conditions, and I use the AND operator to join the two subconditions together. So that's why I use the return type as boolean for this private method. And since the inner method is going to give me a boolean value, when I call the high memory high storage method in the public method called is flagship server, I have to make the method to return a boolean value. So it is going. This method is going to match the output coming from the private method. Okay, let me save it first. And then, how can I make use of the computer class to find out whether a computer is a flagship server? Let me open the driver class. Okay, I have a computer object whose reference variable is called server1, and this server1 is storing the reference of the object whose memory size is 32 GB and the storage size is 10 TB, because I use double as the data type of the storage size variable. It is better for me to use 10.0 to indicate that I really entered a double value, which becomes the actual parameter of the computer object. Now let me call the inner methods by calling the public method. How can I do that? Okay, I can simply call the public method by using this format: reference variable dot public method name. Let me save it and run it. Okay, the answer is false. Why? The reason is that I need to check the inner method to see whether a computer object given by this notation is really a flagship server. I need the memory size to be at least 64 GB, but my computer object has only 32 GB. So the first condition already fails. When the first condition fails, I don't really need to check whether the second condition is valid or not. And actually, for this particular object, the second condition also fails because my object has only 10 terabytes of storage. But for a flagship server, the storage has at least 12 terabytes. So false here and false there would give me false as the combined result. So I will get false as the answer. So when I call the is flagship server method, I will reach the return statement on line number 11. When I reach line number 11, I will simply go to the private method to compare the memory size and the storage size with my desired values, which are presented as the local variables of the inner method. So since this the inner method is having the keyword private, I can't really call it directly from the outside world. So for even for the driver class, I can't call the private method directly. Okay, you can see the error here. The inner method is actually non-visible to the driver class. So that means I'm not able to have this notation. Reference variable dot inner method name. When I do so, I will have a syntax error. So that's the reason why a private method is not accessible outside the class declaration. The only class that can access the private method is simply the class that includes the inner method. For my case, it is the computer class only. So, and that's why the is flagship server method is able to access the inner method. The reason is that the inner method is part of the computer class, and this inner method is accessible within the scope of the computer class. So another method from the computer class can access the private method directly. So after the discussion here, I hope you are able to understand the usage of inner methods. And of course, I have to say that this application is for illustration only. For my situation, it is better to just use one method. That means you can simply combine the two classes to just one class in my example to make the presentation a bit more understandable. We actually don't really need to decompose the method into two methods. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, feel free to leave your comments on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.